Hello everyone and welcome to the Ultimate Gaming Channel. Thank you for joining me in the 7th episode of Alan Wake 2 walkthrough. So we will just continue where we left off in the first in the last episode. Continue to looking for the signs in the tunnel. So let's go. And the new scene, derailed train.
But it was here for a reason.
New plot board. Okay. So words of power are all this. I missed one here, but I will pick up that later. So now let's just continue. Do all this. And
what element I found would drive the story.
Let's try missing FBI agent. So what we have here now?
Hello? Anyone there?
Door is still locked, dead. So it's probably this one. Yeah, now we have the door.
The cult poured the gasoline over the train car. An iron cage.
Yeah, buddy. And another echo is here.
Go on, ma'am.
This is where the history of the cult gets genuinely disturbing. The cultists track down the torchbearers living in the tunnels. They lock the poor folks up in a derailed subway car, douse it in gasoline. Yeah.
Charming.
It turns into a bit of a ghost story
element.
After that. They say the dark smoke from the fire still roams the tunnels searching for new victims to devour.
There are no happy endings in this city.
The story thread felt important.
All right.
I could use it in one of the scenes I found.
Let's try to change the scene now, back to this one. So now what is different? This changed. And here is items to pick up, guys. Very nice. But now let's change back to the next scene, torchbearers. And okay, let's try now.
The world around me.
So not this door.
The subway car had become a burnt husk.
Okay.
I can get through it now.
So now we can go through the car. I can't run here. Come on, buddy.
None of this was real. It was unreal.
We are on the other side now. And we can open this door now. Yeah. Very nice. Let's head down. Now a quick check to the map. And we are right here, okay, so two words of power are here. And one is there. Okay. Word of action found. More sneaking. Let's go down now. Game is saved, very nice. And now
wake.
Lots of shadows there. There is another power. Can I take it from here maybe? Now I need to go a bit inside.
I'm awake.
Yeah, lots of shadows. I will just take the power and get out of here. Loot everything here. Maybe here more loot.
Alan, wake.
Yes. Oh, nice.
Wake.
Nothing left here, I think. Yeah, quick check and get out of here. Lots of damn shadows here. And we are going down now, okay. So now again the lights.
My path was blocked. I had to find a
way through. Nice, it's another save room, guys.
The lights would help me.
I will leave maybe. Actually, I will not leave anything. Just quick save here and we go. Let's see now this with the lights. Take this one. Take this one too. So we need to go there, but let's see. So now I can go here. Initiation. We can leave the light here. Let's see now what happened. So take this light now. And yeah, passage to the right opened. Now let's just see. So words of power. Okay. Let's go here first. There are shadows, but power is there. Yeah, word of lamp found without fighting. Like that. Let's head here now. Take this light too. And more shadows. Another power. Word of power. Okay, so now let's go here then. I don't wanna end the end of line, story to tell. New scene. So let's loot this first. Nothing. All three empty.
This new plot beat would carry me deeper into the story.
So let's try with the murder cult.
The hall had changed into the murder cult's hideout. The cultists were close now. A dark presence rising from the depths.
Pause the video, guys. So nothing else different is here. Oh, but an echo.
Witnessed something here that made him run scared. Whether the summoning ritual had been a bona fide supernatural event or the mass psychosis of stark raving lunatics, it didn't change the facts. The cult was messing with things no one should mess with.
The ritual was a vital part of the story, the key to reaching the murder site.
Okay.
The new story beat fit the story perfectly.
But let's go with Torchbearer first. So nothing much happened. Let's use the new plot. In the collapsed tunnel. Let's go now there. Game saved more shadows and just try and run fast by them. With the sneak ability. Yeah guys, thank you for not attacking me now. This path opened. Buddy.
Shit, shit, shit!
Not again. Ooh, okay. Two of them almost got me. Now let's just quick loot the room. I think. Yeah, more bullets, more health, okay. And another word of power for the faction found. So I didn't actually use this amount of health total. Then here, this one. Yeah, stealth fully and health regeneration. Now let's go further. So what we have here? Nothing. Oh, another echo, okay. So let's then...
Turns out the cultists weren't the only ones using the tunnels.
Okay.
Hidden graffiti signs marked secret routes. I kept hearing whispers around burn barrels and underground.
Just check here. Nothing. Okay, let's go.
Wake.
Include this. Let's go. Okay.
Come on.
Why so many of them now that I need to fight? Fix another save room, guys. Very nice. So now I will take this one, just quick save, and we can continue. So let's go. But just quick check because I missed this. The power here, and at the start I will just now quickly run and pick up those two guys, and then we will continue here where we're supposed to. So unlock this door, and then I'm gonna just now speed up this. So I missed one loot here, but it's empty, and I missed this word of power here in this wagon. So word of a gun found. I will speed up this a bit again now. I missed another power here. In word of power.
Wake.
So it's just here. That's word of war. Okay, double barrel shotgun. So now we can go where we should. And we are here where we should be. So let's continue now with the story and everything.
I could imagine this murder cult performing their macabre acts beyond the collapsed tunnel.
Let's try with the synths. And another echo.
One of the torchbearers painted the tree there. The tree of knowledge. The tree of life with its roots reaching down to hell. It could have been a Christmas tree for all the good it did him.
Okay, so... And the last scene.
The scene
tunnel is unblocked.
The dark presence.
What the fuck is this? Come on.
Fuck.
Run, man.
Fuck.
Run, run, run. Run into the train, come on. Let's go. What the hell? To the save room, man. Yeah, come on. Fucking hell. Oh my god.
I couldn't hear the dark presence. It was gone.
Thank god. So let's just save here, guys, and continue. Let's go. So now we can go through the tunnel. Let's
the tunnel was open now. I could get through. Shit.
What? Again, the dark presence. Come on, man. Come on, wake.
Dark presence. I had seen it before. I remembered now. It was always out there, hunting me.
Long tunnels. Where are we gonna end up now? What the fuck? Where we are now, at the murder site, the body.
I had found the murder site. Somehow the victim's heart was the key.
What the?
Something had shifted. I felt an overwhelming closeness to home. An FBI agent? Who are you?
What is this? Who are you?
She can hear me.
I'm Saga Anderson, FBI.
We can't hear you.
This is Alan Wake. I'm trapped here. The dark place. Under Cauldron Lake.
Cauldron Lake. Are you?
I'm trying to escape. I'm making progress, but I'm in danger. The dark presence. Help me. Please, help me. I could sense it. I was closer to home. Had the woman in the vision helped me somehow? Something had changed outside Parliament Tower, where I had lived with Alice. It was out there, waiting for me.
All right. And the end of part. Very nice. Well, let's go then. get to the apartment in Parliament Tower. Game save, very nice. And another echo.
Stepping to the murder site, I'd felt it hanging in the air. A meaning, the violent emotion of the act, like a cloud of wrath. The dead eyes of the victim staring at something you couldn't see, and yet making you aware of it. Something had soaked into this place on a molecular level, overlapping with your meaningless existence. Regression to something you had managed to forget. Marking you. Taking you for a ride. Making you crazier.
Okay, man. And where we are now. And yeah, that was that locked door from the start. So yes, now subway is all cleared. Let's get out of here.
The station had changed. I was closer now.
I'll take this light too, actually. Why not? Three lights now. And there's the Parliament Tower.
Parliament Tower. Our home in New York. Was I really this close to being home? Going up to our apartment? Would I be home? Or was this just an echo of the real thing? Even then, the murder site had brought me one step closer to escape.
Let's head inside. Another echo. Come on, man.
Maybe he was a victim. The writer. Maybe he was a victim. The cult, using his words. Or maybe he was the monster behind it all. Either way, Alice Wake, his ex, she knew things. It was there in her art for all to see. A cry for help. The darkness she'd witnessed. And that put her in danger.
Was Alice here? In the story?
We will find out soon. So let's head to the elevator. Look for Alice. And the initiation tree haunting.
Alice's photo equipment. Set to go off when the door opens. Alice, this is a photo of Scratch. How did Alice get this? Is he stalking her?
Let's check the apartment.
This is the door to my study, where I wrote my books. This symbol wasn't here. Alice's video camera. No memory card inside.
We need a memory card. So probably not in the kitchen. But what is
Alice's
this?
Memory card.
Here is the memory card. All right. It says part number one. So more of everything. Let's use the memory card now. And
when I was younger, photography was everything to me. I moved to New York thinking I'd make it as an artist. And then I met Alan. We had a good thing. We were both dedicated by our creative ambitions. The only difference was that Alan's work made money. He brought me work when he could. I took his promo shots. Created covers for his books. I'm sure he forced his publisher into it. I was taking photos, just not my photos.
Okay.
And that nod at me. Things got complicated sometimes, but that's life, right?
Yeah, of course.
We loved each other. Then Alan hit a block. I brought out a meaner side of him. One I didn't like. I set up a trip to see a doctor in Washington. I didn't tell him until we got there. We argued. Things went wrong.
Am I dead?
About 6 years ago, I started hearing noises in the night. Typewriter keys clacking. Voices. Alan was back. Haunting me.
Okay.
Then it got violent. It was Alan. And yet, it was a monster. He always did have anger in him. Around the apartment with motion sensors and flashes. Now, when the monster comes, I turn it into art.
Very nice.
My nightmares caught on film. And this is the focus of my new exhibition. To show people the world is so much darker than they ever knew.
Oh my God.
I'm calling this exhibit The Dark Place.
Okay.
Alice. Scratch was terrorizing her. Why?
We entered the dark place. The attic.
I sat in the writer's room and wrote a story. Initiation. To project myself through the dark place, to look for a way out. The story had brought me here, brought me nowhere. Looped me back. I was writing the story. And in the story, I now stepped into the writer's room. But there was no one here writing.
Okay. back to Saga.
Okay, let's recap what you've told us so far, Ellen. For the past 13 years, you've been trapped in a nightmare dimension called the Dark Place.
Yeah.
It's like New York, but it's not New York. And can be reached from the bottom of Cauldron Lake, but it's not really under the lake. And after all this time, you've managed to get out.
Yeah, yeah.
But so has your evil doppelganger, Mr. Scratch? Or is it the Dark Presence?
Both. It's interchangeable. He's Scratch when he looks like me, but he can change into this other form.
And Scratch, the Dark Presence, wants to rewrite the world in his own image.
Which would be in your image, as he looks just like you.
And turn the world into a fucking nightmare.
During Deerfest, which is scheduled to take place in a couple of days. You got out of the Dark Place by writing a novel, the pages we've been finding. But your double edited it into a horror story that's now changing reality, taking over people,
yeah.
Making them crazy, bringing the Dark Place to Bright Falls.
Yes, fiction coming in contact with the Dark Place can change reality. The story is coming true, soaking into everything, like darkness when night falls. But last time...
This will be back in 2010.
Yes, last time it didn't happen all at once. The story came true bit by bit as it unfolded. And that Dark Presence was still bound to the lake. I stopped it before it got the ending it wanted. Before it broke free. Based on that, there's still time.
Which brings us to your magical light switch.
The clicker. Magical doesn't quite cover it. Scratch wants it to bring about his ending. That can't happen. If I can get the clicker, I can send him back to the Dark Place, make all the shit go away.
I need a clicker.
Look, I know it's batshit crazy. My memory is full of holes, and I'm not sure how much I can trust. It's like a half-forgotten dream.
Mr. Wake, Alan, we've seen our share of batshit crazy in the past 24 hours. What I want to know is, why am I? Why are we written into the story?
I think I saw you. Or a vision of you in the Dark Place. I think you helped me reach out and escape somehow. With that in the story, Scratch would have edited it to get to you. To hurt you.
Yeah.
We are all in danger.
Okay, let's go. Back to playing with Saga. So,
it's
okay.
Insane. And there's so much of it. Have you ever heard of the cult of the tree?
Creepy bunch. In the habit of wearing deer masks, performing murder rituals, victims turning into monsters possessed by darkness. Possibly inspired by a horror story written by a certain author. Ring any bells?
The cult. Yes. Yes. They have the clicker.
Would have the clicker.
If the cult has the clicker, does that make them Scratch's followers? How are you so certain they even have the clicker?
They could be working for Scratch. I don't remember. It's all confused.
Alan, if I'm gonna act on this information, you need to be honest with me.
Yeah, of course.
Is he confused? Or is he hiding something?
So let's do a profiling.
Wake said the cult has the clicker. How does he know?
The writer is the reader. The next chapter, the next chapter, the next chapter. Keep the pages safe, the dark shining of the words.
Wake is hiding pages. That's how he knows the cult has the clicker.
Now the Scratch.
Wake has a double. Mr. Scratch. Where is he now?
A cloud of wrath wears my face. The dark place in your place. Scratching out my body of work.
Scratch is here. In Washington. He's hunting Wake.
All right, and now this one.
Scratch looks just like Wake. Why?
Don't wake up the dreamer if your life is a dream. I swam to the shore, but the water is rising.
Wake and Scratch are clearly connected. Maybe Scratch got out because Wake did. Or vice versa.
Let's jump to manuscript pages. Murder Site and the Cult of the Tree. If you want to read this, just pause the video, guys. The radio, okay. So, case board now.
Wake just gave us a lot of information. But this clicker seems like a good place to start. If we find that, then we find the cult.
All right. Let's add the clues. So, nursery rhymes and Cult of the Tree. We have this here. And okay, I will do this too, because...
Think.
The FBC is definitely playing with things they don't fully understand.
So that's all from
and that all
okay.
Goes
well. Mr. Wake, I know you have more pages of the manuscript on you.
You don't understand how vital these pages are. They're the only way I can know what's coming.
You're not the only one trying to solve this. This is our job.
Okay. Here.
Yeah, give the manuscript pages, man.
Be careful with them.
I will.
Inside the trailer, at the outskirts of Watery, Saga had seen Wake's fabled clicker for the first time, in the hands of the Cult of the Tree. A cultist stared at her. She drew her weapon.
So let's see the manuscript page, trailer. All right. The goal is learn more about the clicker. So... And the trail of the cult.
The Cult of the Tree has the clicker Wake told me about. They're a part of all this.
All right.
It's all on the page. The clicker, the cult. Okay, I'll head to Watery and find this trailer. Casey, you stay here and keep an eye on Mr. Wake.
Got it.
No, you need me there.
No dice, pal. This is an FBI investigation, and I don't see a badge on that flannel.
From now on, you can switch between Alan and Saga stories via the bucket in the janitor's break room. Feel free to play in whatever order you choose. Okay. So let's see now, just drive to Watery. Okay, and continue there. So, I think I will end the episode here, guys, because it's already too long, so, yeah. Thank you for joining me in this episode number 7 of Alan Wake 2 walkthrough. If you liked what you see, please consider subscribing, and join me in another episode number 8 in this Alan Wake 2 walkthrough. And see you then. Bye, guys.